An Australian man who claims he can cure a range of diseases, including AIDS, has been threatened with jail if he returns to Papua New Guinea. It's feared that more than 500,000 PNG nationals may be infected with HIV-AIDS in the next 15 years if nothing is done. And authorities are worried that false treatments will hinder their attempts to prevent its spreading. Papua New Guinea correspondent Steve Marshall reports.
Lucy Ravu may not be a trained nurse, but people flock to her home in Port Moresby for this unusual therapy. She suspects her latest visitor is HIV positive, but believes she can heal them.
I think it's, a miracle. And it's better than medicine.
As two small magnetic plates send electric pulses into his wrist, the patient drinks this special water, which Lucy Ravu claims has extraordinary powers.
It cleans the blood, purifies the blood. So that's how it, cleans the system out and it kills all the germs, and that's how the person gets better.
Lucy Ravu was trained to carry out her controversial treatment by this man, Australian Brian Marshall.
He told me that this product here, it can cure cancer, TB, HIV, and any type of sicknesses.
T cell is the eyes that tells the body it's sick.
And this video posted on the internet shows Brian Marshall during a recent visit to PNG.
There's Margaret. Margaret.
She's been cured of AIDS. She's now recovering.
Brian Marshall claims he can rid PNG of HIV-AIDS and other infectious diseases using his electro-water technique.
In the neighbourhood of 400 people that have been cured of all diseases, ranging from HIV-AIDS to malaria to TB, gonorrhea, syphilis, because they're blood-borne diseases. And what I've basically done is able to put an electrical current through the blood at the wrist level, which kills off all viruses and pathogens and germs in the blood.
Papua New Guinea is in the grip of an HIV-AIDS epidemic. According to AusAid, if the virus goes unchecked for the next 15 years, more than 500,000 people will be infected. The man in charge of the PNG government's response to the epidemic is outraged by Brian Marshall's claims he can cure HIV-AIDS.
This is fraudulent. We know that this water cannot cure anything. It is all just typical confidence tricking, playing with people's mind and playing with their wallet, draining them.
Brian Marshall says the water contains an alternative medicine product known as colloidal silver. While it's illegal to make medical claims about its effectiveness in Australia, that's not the case in PNG.
I've seen no evidence at all in any medical literature or even anecdotally to support a claim of that sort, that there's any effect of colloidal silver, magnets, electric currents, separately or together for the treatment or cure of HIV infection in humans.
International development law expert David Patterson says there is a global need to regulate the advertising of cures for HIV-AIDS.
It's not a new problem. We've seen this in a number of developing countries with a more extensive epidemic. There's certainly a role for the law in regulating the advertising of cures for HIV, because we don't have a cure for HIV at the moment.
Up until today you had AIDS. Now you haven't got AIDS. From today on, that's finished.
Brian Marshall does not see the danger in what he's doing. His reasoning is alarming.
There is a big backlash. We can come in and do it so cheaply and so conveniently and to the point it's curing people, whereas I believe that there is a conspiracy to keep the AIDS virus to kill off people.
What should be done immediately is to establish that this is a fraud case, and if he sets foot in PNG, he should be arrested and locked up.
Steve Marshall reporting.